This is June 2001. So this question, it's a CDF. So this is a CDF, and CDF is expressed cumulative, is cumulative density function. The random variable is continuous. It's a continuous random variable. So the expression is expressed as CDF equals expression. The limit is from 1 to 2. And above this, since it means cumulative probability, so if you have total probability from here, anything below that, the probability is going to be 0, and anything above that is going to be 1, because the total probability is 1. Now the first question is, you have to find probability density function, or PDA. PDA, probability density function. That means you have to find an expression for the probability. So for that, you have to make sure that you break this down. So you break it down like this. PDA, let me do something brighter. So PDF equals to the differentiation of CDF. You break it down. That's how it works. So question number A is going to be, the PDF equals to differentiation of the CDF, which is 1 by 27 minus x cubed plus 6x squared minus 5, bracket closed. Now since this is a constant, I can either multiply it with the entire expression, or I can just keep it here, because it doesn't really matter when you differentiate a coefficient, because the coefficient remains. Let me show you, for example, when you differentiate something like d by dx of a constant ax, the answer is a. When you differentiate d by dx of a constant ax to the power 2, the answer is a, and x squared is differentiated as twice x. If you differentiate d by dx of a x to the power 3, the answer is a times x cubed is differentiated 3x squared. So the constant is there, so it doesn't really matter if you keep the constant here or multiply it out. So when you do this, it's going to be minus 3x squared plus 12x, and when you differentiate the constant, it's 0. Remember from the basic rule, d by dx of any constant. Now here we don't have any coefficient of x, just a constant, it's going to be 0. Okay, so we have this. This is the expression for PDF, but it is important to remember that this is just an expression for PDF. We have to define PDF. So the definition of PDF is going to be, you write PDF, then you give this braces, and you write down the expression. You don't have to write what happens before that as they're writing cumulative. You just have to write it like expression. So 1 by 27 minus 3x squared plus 12x. And the limit is going to be the same as the CDF. Both the PDF and the CDF have the same limit. So it's going to be 1 to 4. So 1, 2, 4. And here, anything outside this, the probability is going to be 0. So you write 0. Otherwise, so remember, in case of PDF, this is how you express it. You write PDF equals to the expression, the limit, since this is cumulative, it doesn't really matter whether you give the equal to sign or not, just follow the question, and you write the probability is going to be 0 otherwise. That's it. So that's how you write down the PDF. The PDF is expression and limit 0 otherwise. Okay. Now the next question, after you have the PDF, is the mode. In order to find the mode, you need PDF. Remember, for the mode, we need the PDF. So there are a number of ways of finding the mode. The mode is the data with the highest probability or the highest frequency. So here, we need the mode. Mode is the data with the highest probability. So this is a curve. If you think of this as a coordinate geometry picture, it is quadratic, minus x squared. So the picture is going to be a parabola. So when finding a mode from a PDF that is a parabola, it's best to do the turning point. We can also find the mode from the sketch, but since we don't have any sketch here, it's the next question. Best thing to do when you have a parabola or a cubic, the best thing to do is to find the turning point, because that is going to be the highest point. Remember, the turning point is the highest point. So if you have a picture like minus x squared, so the parabola is going to be like this. So the mode is going to be the value of x, where you have the highest point. So let's do this. So f prime x, so for mode, the turning point, or f prime x, which means dy by dx, by the way, is 0. So therefore, now we have to find the derivative of this. Remember, previously we found the derivative for the PDF, because the CDF was given. Now we are doing in terms of coordinate geometry, in terms of Cartesian coordinate system, where the turning point, the gradient is 0, because it's the highest point. The definition of mode is the data at the highest point, or the data with the highest frequency or probability. So if we differentiate this again, let's keep the constant as the constant. So minus 3x squared is minus 6x, and 12x is 12 equals to 0. So we can just send the constant to the other side. 0 divided by 1 by 27 is going to be 0. Minus 6x plus 12 equals to 0. Therefore, minus 6x equals to minus 12. If you send this minus 6 downstairs, it's going to be 2. You have to restate it. Mode is 2. So mode is 2. So that's that. The next question is, you have to do the sketch. So let's do the sketch. Remember, when we think about sketch, it's just a simple Cartesian coordinate system sketch. So this is x, the random variable. This is fx. This is the PDF. Remember, we cannot sketch the CDF because it's total. We have to sketch this. So the expression is here. The limit is from 1 to 4. So put here 1. Put here 4. The sketch doesn't have to be that accurate. So if I put here 1, it is 1 square, so minus 3. And this is 1 into 12 is 12. So 12 minus 3 is 9. 9 by 27. Let me keep it here, 9 by 27, so that I can have a comparison. So 9 by, of course, it is 1 by 3, but I want to have a comparison. So this is the point here. Okay. The next point is 4. So 4 square is 16. So 16 threes are 48, so minus 48, and 12 fours are 48, so 48 minus 48 is 0, so this is 0 here. So now I don't need the comparison anymore, so I can just write it as 1 by 3. So this is 1 by 3. So now I have to join this. Now I know this is a quadratic. Fx PDF is quadratic, so I don't know exactly what's going to happen, but I know the turning point is 2, the mode is 2, so let me just write it like this. So this is the mode, I have to show it here. So this is the sketch. So sketch is just a general sketch. You take the lower limit and put it in the PDF, then you take the upper limit and put it in the PDF, and that's it. And just follow the shape. Question number D is, you have to find the mean or the expected value. Okay, in order to find the mean, the rule is expected value, which is the mean, we can also write mu here, is integration. Since this is cumulative, to add up, we have to integrate. That's what is done in cumulative addition, in summation, when the data is cumulative. So it starts at 4, it starts at 1, that means greater than 1 can be 1.0000000001. That's greater than 1. So how do you know? It's more or less the same thing. And less than 4 can be 3.99999999, same thing as 4. So we have to integrate. So the limit is going to be from 1 to 4. And we write the random variable, which is x. And we write the expression, which is fx. So fx here is 1 by 27 minus 3x squared plus 12x. And close the bracket here, and dx. So remember, the expected value is, let me write it here, the expected value is expected value equals to the overall limit, random variable into PDF dx. So that's the expected value. In order to do this, the basic idea of integrals has to be followed. For example, integration of constant x dx is going to be a x squared by 2, and we have to give a plus c if there is no limit. Since there is a limit, we don't have to give a plus c here in this definite integral. Then if you have an integration of a x squared dx, which we have here, it's going to be, the constant is going to be the same, x cubed by 3. Again, if it is, it has no limit, then we have to write plus c for indefinite integral, but this is definite integral. And we have a constant, if you have a constant, integration of any constant, it's just that x, ax plus c. So this is how it works. So getting back to the sum, we have to integrate. So 1 to 4, if I multiply it with x, I want to keep the 1 by 27 outside. So that would be minus 3x cubed plus 12x squared dx. Now let me keep the 1 by 27 outside the integration. I can keep that 1 to 4 minus 3x cubed plus 12x squared dx equals to 1 by 27. Now let me integrate. Third bracket is given, that's the convention. So minus 3 is the coefficient. X cubed is integrated as x to the power 4 by 4. 12, this is integrated as x cubed by 3. And we write 1 to 4. So this is going to be 1 to 27. Now let's put the limit. It is important to show the steps as you put the limit. It's part of the sum. Now I can simplify this. I can cancel this 3 and 4. 3, 4 is 12. Now let me put the limit. This is minus 3 by 4. 4 to the power 4 plus 4. 4 cubed. So this is the first one. Leave a bracket here. Minus. Now I have to put 1. So minus 3 by 4. 1 to the power 4 plus 4. 1 cubed. Okay. So this is going to be minus 192. Plus 256 minus 13 by 4, and that is this. Now we have to multiply by 1 by 27, so 1 by 27, so that is 2 whole 1 by 4, which is 9 by 4. So 9 by 4, that is the expected value. So 9 by 4 is the expected value. It is important to check that the expected value is not the probability, it is the mean, so it should be somewhere around 1 to 4. The limit is 1 to 4, so it should be somewhere around 1 to 4, so 2.25, something like that. The next question is, you have to show that f, that means CDF, cumulative, f of mu, mu is mean, so f of 9 by 4, or 2.25, so 9 by 4 is 2.25. So what we have to do is, we have to find the value of this CDF. So let me do it here. F of 9 by 4 equals to, let's do the calculation. So minus 2.25 cubed equals to this plus 6 into 2.25 squared equals to this minus 5 equals to this divided by 27 into 1 by 27 means divided by 27. This is going to be 0.518. Therefore f mu means 2.25 is greater than 0.5 because it's 0.518. The final question is, show that the median lies between the mode and the mean. First of all, the mode is 2 and the mean is 2.25, 9 by 4 we just found here, it's 9 by 4. So in order to show that the median lies here, so we have to write down the rule for the median. So this is the rule. F x equals to 0.5 for median. So fx equals to 0.5 for median. Now since in the previous sum we already know if we put the value of mean 2.25, we get something more than the value of 0.5, which is, so this is, the mean is going to be greater than the median. If it was the median, the value of CDF would be 0.5, but when we put the mean, we found a value which is 0.518, which is greater than the median. Now we have to check with the mode. So when we put the mode, so question number F, the mode is 2, so F2 equals to 1 by 27 minus 2.25 cubed plus 6.25 squared minus 5. Let's do the calculation. So this is going to be minus 1 by 27 minus 2 cubed plus 6 2 squared minus 5. So this is going to be minus 8. So minus 8 plus 2 squared is 4. 4 6 is 24. 24 minus 5. 11 divided by 27. That is 4.407. So we know 2.25 is 0.518. That means when we put the mode, it is 0.407. When we put the mean, it is 0.518. And in order for the median, it has to be 0.5. So it is either the mode is less than the median and the mean is more than the median. So you can write hence the median is between the mode and mean. So that's the question. So this is another some continuous distribution. In a computer game, a star moves across a screen with constant speed, taking 1 second to travel from one side to the other. So we have a screen and some sort of a star is moving here. The player can stop this star by pressing a key. The object of the game is to stop the star in the middle of the screen, pressing the key exactly 0.5 seconds after the star appears. Given that the player actually presses the key T seconds after the star appears, a simple model of the game assumes that T is continuous uniform distribution. That's the main thing. The story is not the most important thing. This is, it's a continuous uniform distribution and the interval is this. You have to remember, for continuous uniform distribution, if the interval is A to B, then the PDF is 1 by D minus A. It's a constant because the probability cannot change no matter what the limit, because it has does not have any variable X. It's constant. The expected value by symmetry is going to be A plus B by 2. The variance is going to be B minus A whole squared divided by 12. And the sketch is going to be just a horizontal line. So if this is A and this is B, that's the line. And this is the PDF 1 by B minus A. So it's pretty straightforward. It's a constant and the probability is a constant. And it's a uniform continuous distribution. So the first question, what we have to do is write down the probability. So always draw a rectangular picture here. So this is going to be limit is from 0 to 1. And the PDF is going to be 1 by B minus A. So 1 by 1 minus 0 is 1. So we have to find the probability 0.2. So this is the region we are looking for. So rectangular, if a rectangle, so 0 to 0.2 is 0.2 and this is 1. So this is going to be 0.2 into 1. So this is 0.2. That's it. Question number B. Write down the expected value of t. So the expected value is going to be a plus b by 2. So this is going to be 0 plus 1 by 2, which is half, which is 0.5. Now variance. Use integration to find the variance. Now remember, variance can be found using the formula. This is the formula, b minus a whole squared by 12. So that means 1 minus 0, which is 1, whole squared, which is 1, divided by 12. The variance should be 1 by 12. But they specifically told us to use integration. So let us use integration here. So variance equals to e x squared. So but they are using the random variable, a different random variable. So I need to use what they're using. So variance of t, e t squared minus mean squared. Mean is nothing but the expected value. So in order to do that, let's use integration. So et squared is integration of 0 to 1 t squared ft dt. You need to remember from general distribution, if its expected value, I'm using x here, it is going to be limit x fx dx. If it is e x squared, it is going to be limit x squared fx dx. Okay, so let's get back. So since ft here is 1, because the PDF is going to be 1 by b minus a, 1 by 1 minus 0, which is 1. So I'm going to write only t squared into 1, so t squared. So this is t cubed by 3, and limit is 0 to 1, so this will be 1 by 3 minus 0, which is 1 by 3. So therefore, the variance et squared is 1 by 3, and mu squared is 0.5 squared, so half squared. So this is going to be 1 by 12 using the calculator. So check here, by the formula of uniform distribution, b minus a, which is 0 minus 1 minus 0, which is 1, divided by 12. So we got 1 by 12 using integration. It's the same thing. So the next question is, a group of 20 children, so they gave us information about 20 children, find the probability that no more than 4. Now, no more than 4 means 4 is the maximum. That means probability of, if I use the random variable x, it has to be less than or equal to 4. No more means maximum 4. Stop the star in less than 0.2 seconds. Now look here, there's a special sum. They're giving us three information. One of the information is in the previous sum. Less than 0.2 second, less than 0.2 second, less than 0.2 second, the probability is 0.2. It's a coincidence, they're the same. This is seconds, this is the probability 0.2 or 20%. So less than 0.2 second, the probability is 0.2. So when you have three information, remember, the probability of success is 0.2, n equals to 20, and you have to find the probability of x is less than or equals to 4. So this x is less than or equals to 4. So we can convert it into a binomial distribution, and now we can use the random variable. So in order to do that, I can write it as x is 20 point and 0.2. Probability of x is less than or equals to 4. So this is going to be a binomial distribution. I don't have to define it. I don't have to define the random variable. It's all right. But I have to use a different alphabet altogether for the random variable, because t was the uniform distribution and this letter x is a new distribution, the binomial distribution. So we have to find the value from the table. So this is the binomial distribution table, and we're looking for n equals to 20. So this would be right here. So n equals to 20 is right here. Now what we're looking for, p equals to 0.2. So if you scroll up, you'll see that 0.2 is this column, right here. So this column is 0.2. Remember this, is 0.2 right here, and this is n. Now we are looking for the random variable. This is a cumulative distribution. We're looking for x is less than or equals to 4. So we're looking for that. So this is 4, and that means less than. Cumulative means this is less than or equals to 4. So that means this thing right here, so 0.6296. So 0.6296 is the probability. Next question is, the children are allowed to practice this game so that this continuous uniform distribution is no longer applicable. That means, what do you expect the mean and the variance? You see, mean, it means what is on an average, how much time are they taking? And variance means what is the fluctuation of those values. So as you see, the mean should, you know, remain the same. So the mean should remain same, which is 0.5. But the variance, the fluctuation, variance is the dispersion, the fluctuation, that should decrease. The variance should decrease because they're practicing the game more and more. Okay, this is a long sum. We have one more part. It says, it is found that a more appropriate model of the game when played by experienced player assumes the PDF. And this is the PDF. Now, this is a two-expression PDF. It's a double-barreled PDF. Now, using this model, we have to show that the probability is this. Now, when you're finding the probability from the PDF, you have to understand the limit is from 0 to 1. The limit is from 0 to 1, but they have broken the limit into two parts, 0 to 0.5 and 0.5 to 1. When you're going to find the probability, you have to check where does the limit fall. So t is less than 0.2, so 0.2 is here. So less than 0.2 means from 0 to 0.2. So this is the this is what you're going to look for, because less than 0.2 means it has to end at 0. Now you have to check for the expression. You know, probability of something, suppose x is less than a, it has to be from a to some upper limit, and it has to be the PDF. So for finding the probability, you always integrate the PDF. So since there are two expressions here, for finding the probability, you have to decide on what expression you want to use. You want to use this expression, 4t, because 0.2 is from here, lies here. So the sum is going to be probability of t is less than 0.2 equals to integration of from 0 to 0.2. So 0.2 is going to be the upper limit and 0 is going to be the lower limit. And the expression is 4t. So when we integrate this, this will be 4t squared by 2. And the limit is going to be from 0 to 0.2. So we cancel 2 to the 4. So let's put the value 2.2 squared minus 0. So 2.2 squared is going to be 0.2 squared into 2. This is 0.08 as it's mentioned. Question number G. So a group of 75 experienced players, so we have 75 here, then find the probability that more than 7, that means probability of, if we had x greater than 7, less than 0.2 second. Notice this is the same as this, just like the previous sum. Just like the previous sum, we have now three information. The number of children, people who take less than 0.2 seconds, and the probability that we have to find. So again, we have to convert this into a binomial distribution. So we have already used the letter x. So we can write binomial 75 and point. This time the probability of 0.2 less than 0.2 is 0.08, so the success is going to be 0.08. And we have to find the probability of y, probability that more than 7, so y is greater than 7. Now, in order to do this sum, we cannot look up the table, because in the table, the highest value that we have, it's 50. And the probability is 0.05, and the highest probability is 0.5. So we cannot look at the table. There's nothing else in the table. That's it. The table ends. So the highest value of n is this. So we cannot do this. But we can use an approximation. And this, that's why they mention use an approximation. So in order to use the approximation, the best approximation for binomial, for since discrete is discrete, is Poisson. Of course, if it's a very large number, the best would be the normal distribution of the approximation. So let's check whether the normal distribution, the Poisson distribution, can be used. So 75 into 0.08 is 6. It can be used. So we can use another alphabet. We can write using Poisson distribution as an approximation. So we can use lambda equals to 75.08. Please always show this presentation. Therefore, I can use the letter A. I cannot use the letter Z or Z because it is used by the standard normal distribution. So Poisson, this is 6. So we're going to use a is greater than 7. So now, since the Poisson distribution is also cumulative, so greater than 7 means 8, 9, 10, on and on. So if I write 1 minus probability of a is less than or equals to 7, then it is correct, discrete. So we need greater than 7 means same as a is greater than or equals to 8. So 1 minus a is less than or equals to 7. Let's look up the Poisson distribution. So this is the Poisson distribution, and the value of lambda or mean of the Poisson distribution is given here. Notice this is also a cumulative distribution. Everything is less than or equals to 3 means less than or equals to 3. Let's scroll down. So we're looking for this. So this is lambda equals to 6. We're looking for this column, and we're looking for x is less than or equals to 7. So less than or equals to 7 is this 0.7440. Let's write 0.7440. 1 minus that. 1 minus 0.7440. That's 0.256. That's give a 0. That's the answer.